Namaste.
All right, so welcome. This is the silent sitting session. Today it'll be for 55 minutes. Just speak a little bit about the nature of the silent sitting. It is, in my experience, that when you literally just sit silent and still every day, 45 minutes twice a day, your nervous system, your neurological wiring, your consciousness will align in such a way that the capacity to do that will expand and improve over time. You begin to have access to that quality that each of us are. You could call it the soul or the sat or the being or the self, that actually has the authority in this life to choose its direction, to choose to follow the impulses of the reactive or conditioned nature, or not to, and to be there attentive to its outcomes, to learn its lessons. So we really don't start traveling this journey on the quality of silence and stillness becomes established enough that we can bring it into our day-to-day lives. This is the test. At first, of course, silence and stillness meditation is difficult. As it says in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna says, "My mind is so restless, turbulent, and stormy. It's like the wind, possible to control." Krishna responded and said, "Yes, I understand it is difficult, but in time, you will be able to overcome this." And neuroscience has actually validated that. And we can reprogram our neurological system so that our consciousness can get focused, organized. And that's what we're coming to. The outer personality coming into an intimate relationship with that central self, the true self. So silent sitting, its very simplicity, its lack of technologies, mantras, all the rest of it, has this extraordinary effectiveness to allow us to directly penetrate into the structures that separate us from that silence and stillness. And in time, it bows to us. It bows to the will that comes from that quality of self. Let us begin. Hari Om Tat Sat. Hari Om Tat Sat. Hari Om Tat Sat Shree. All glory to Gurudev. Namaste. And good night.